gentlemen, and welcome to another edition of Exciting Panther Basketball. We're live here in the William Nix Center on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. About 10 minutes until we get this one underway. The Lady Panthers coming into this one with a disappointing overtime loss to the Southern Jaguars on Saturday night. Folks, let me tell you, it was a barn burner. The Lady Panthers lose it finally by 7 points, but man, oh man, what a great game. Ryan Payne led the way with 18 points, 5 rebounds, and 3 assists. Was perfect from the free throw line. She did it all off the bench. Gerilyn Smith did a fantastic job. Maya Williams, but I think the tail was Phaedra Green and Maya Williams off the bench. We lost Desiree Lewis and Amaya Waddell to an injury, a head injury. They are in concussion protocol right now, and they will not be playing until Wednesday. So Maya Williams and Phaedra Green really stepped up their performance on Saturday night. It wasn't enough, though, to defeat the Southern Jaguars. They hope to rebound here tonight against the Grambling State Tigers, the number 3 team in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. They're coming off a win against Texas Southern. They're hot. They're 7-4 for the Panthers, and 9-3 are down at Grambling. They come in with a good team, folks. It's going to be a real exciting night for you to watch. Want to send a shout out to all of the parents who are watching for both teams. All of the parents for both teams, we want to thank you so much for watching us. Thank you so much for sharing exciting Panther sports across the land, ladies and gentlemen. When we checked on Saturday night, we were right around 2,500 views. Well, as of today, we're at 4,000 views, folks, and that is phenomenal, man. We are just so very, very blessed to have Woodlawn Entertainment, our videographers here, doing a great job. Our sports information director, Miss LaTanya Thurston, who is doing a great job for us here, has really got this thing going on. Now, let me get this on out of the way, ladies and gentlemen. The other day, on Saturday night, some music slipped out. And when I say that, some inappropriate music accidentally was played over the air. My fault. My bad. It's my music. Hey, I made a mistake. I apologize. And for those of you who are offended by that, we sincerely apologize. The views and opinions expressed by Charles Porter do not necessarily reflect those of the athletic department of Prairie View A&M University. I'm just another crazy alum trying to have some fun and keep you watching exciting Panther sports. Stick around. We're going to take a break, folks, and come back with the starting lineup. This is Exciting Panther Basketball.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter coming to you live courtside. The Panthers trying to get back on track, folks. As I said, after a pretty good performance against the Jaguars of Southern University on Saturday night, again, we want to thank all of you who are sharing our videos. We were speaking with some people from off the campus, some sports outlets, and they told us that they were watching us intentively. Now, what that means, I don't know, but there's going to be some opportunity for Prairie View University to step up here in the next couple of months here. So we're really excited about it. And we're going to get ready to give you the starting lineup, ladies and gentlemen, here for the Southern Jaguars. Oh, pardon me, Charles, get it right. For the Grambling State Tigers. Let me tell you a little quick funny story. They still had Jaguars up. Our Jumbotron got stuck, so the Grambling fans were getting on me, and I'm just a sports announcer. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here is the video. It's not going to roll. Well, folks, just bear with us here. We'll find out what's going on. Okay, we're just going to go with the starting lineup, ladies and gentlemen. Starting for the Tigers of Grambling State, a sophomore from Amarillo, Texas, number 5, Zayla Tenner. Starting at point guard, a graduate student from New Orleans, Louisiana, Kaya Wormsley. Anaya Grant is the graduate student from Orlando, Florida. Jordan Carter is a point guard. She's a graduate student from Austin, Texas. And starting at center, Amanda Blake, she is a center, and she is a senior from Somerville, South Carolina. On the other side of the ball, well, the Panthers going with their big five, Robeson, Payne, Smith, Soders, and Williams. That is, Jada Roberson, the graduate student from Indianapolis, Indiana. Also, Ryan Payne, the graduate student from Los Angeles, California, the LSU transfer. Gerlin Smith, the senior from Miramar, Florida, is back. Soders. Jessica Soto is the senior from Houston, Texas, and Amari Williams is going to get the start at the freshman from North Little Rock, Arkansas. Man, I'm excited about this one. The Soto's family are in the stands here from the beginning and the tip-off, and this is going to be a good one, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and talk about the standings. I'm going to try to get a graphic up at halftime with the standings of the Southwestern Athletic Conference for the women. And if you go to www.swag.org, you can get all of that information. I tell you, Mr. Andrew, Okay, I apologize, folks. We got to go with the scores here. Okay, if we go back now and look at the www.swag.org, you can go and get all the information for the Southwestern Athletic Conference. You can also get the standings. So go to swag.org, get the drop-down box, and go to women's basketball, and you can see, as you know, Jackson State is 12-0 in conference play. Grambling State is number 2 at 9-3, with Pine Bluff tied at 9-3. Now, they beat Pine Bluff, so there'll be a game ahead of them. Southern, after defeating Prairie View, is now 8-4 and holding down the fourth spot. Alabama A&M is 6th with a 6-6 record. Florida A&M is 7th with a 6-6 record. And then Bethune-Cookman and Prairie View A&M are battling it out at the bottom for the 8th spot at 5-7. The Lady Panthers trying to get this one going, ladies and gentlemen. Should be a good one. Had to go and get another piece of equipment, the backup piece of equipment, to try to figure out what's going on here with our scoreboard, folks. I want to thank all of our sponsors, Adidas, Sodexo, our friends over at Houston Methodist Sports Medicine, and also our friends at Alumni Affairs, the proud sponsors of Prairie View A&M University Sports. All right, folks, we're about to get this one underway. Those of you who are watching us on the Splendid Media Network, don't forget, hop on over to the Prairie View A&M University YouTube page, www.youtube. In the search box, put PVAMU Athletics. And it'll take you can get the video on the game right now, and we're trying to figure out what's going on. Our score clock is stuck. So as we get ready to reboot everything, folks, bear with us. I want to send a shout-out to the Lady Panthers softball team. Pretty good performance over the weekend, ladies and gentlemen. Go to www.pvpanthers.com and then go to our women's softball area, and on the roster you can see the Lady Panthers started off with Lindenwood last Friday of February the 9th in San Antonio, Texas, in the Incarnate Word Invitational. Dropped the first two games to Buffalo and Lindenwood, came back and lost by one the next day, February 10th, that Saturday, to Lindenwood, and then played Buffalo and lost by 1.8-7. All right, Lindenwood was 1-4, so they lost Saturday 4-1. And they lost Sunday 8-7. And, man, came back, a big comeback on Sunday against Incarnate Word. Just couldn't get it done. They dropped that one 4-3. They head to the HBCU softball tournament and take on Howard on last Friday. Howard pretty good, well-rounded team. Defeated them 10-3. The Panthers came back and defeated Maryland Eastern Shore 9-3 and defeated South Carolina State 8-3. And then I think didn't get the scores for the last couple of games. Rollo, I'm sorry, I left those scores on just a second. Did I bring it? Scores hadn't been updated. We'll get that to you before the end of the game. On Wednesday, North Dakota State. On Wednesday, North Dakota State will come to town. And we will play them on Wednesday in the refurbished, made-over Prairie View A&M University women's softball field, man, and it is fantastic. We're trying to iron out things here in the William Nix Center, folks. We'll take a break and come back, and hopefully we'll have it all ironed out and bring you more exciting. Are we ready? Oh, wait a minute. We'll stay here. Okay, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to stay right here and get this one going. Again, those of you who are watching on the Splendid Media Network, you got to go to www.youtube.com and go to the Prairie View A&M website for the video. You'll still be able to hear the audio here, and we're going to have to turn you around, ladies and gentlemen. I want to send a shout out to Crystal Edwards and Erica Greer. Is it Greer? Erica Edwards. I'm sorry. Just say what you want, but spell my name right. Pardon me. You can't hear me? Well, if you listen more attentively there, how about that? Can you hear me now? All right. Now? Something. All right, ladies and gentlemen, about to get this one underway. Standing at center court is Gerilyn Smith. And let's see. We've got a temporary shot clock, folks, so it's. Let me see. Can I see from the back here? Maybe I can see. Smith getting ready to jump it off with Anijah Grant, the graduate student from Orlando, Florida. Quite a few Floridians here. Here we go. The Tigers control the tip, and coming back over there on the left side with it was Amanda Blake to get the rebound. Now back up top to Anijah Grant. Oh, pardon me. That's 12 to Wormsley, and she'll bring it back around the right side and run the point. Timmer gets it to Grant. Grant puts it up. No good, and coming down with it is Roberson. She had 5 rebounds on Saturday against Southern before fouling out with about 4 minutes left to play in the fourth period. Right side, Soders has it. Now back over on the wing to Ryan Payne. Payne takes it baseline, puts it up, has it partially blocked, and the first foul of the night will be assessed to Wormsley. Like, wait a minute, Timmer or Wormsley? You're going to give that one to Timmer? Okay, Timmer. Caught her with the arm. Here's the replay. Here comes Payne, and yeah, Timmer got her on the left-hand side. And the Panthers will go back to the line for free throws. Ryan Payne on the line for the Panthers. Payne, third in scoring in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. The number one free, oh my goodness. Did I jinx her? She's the number one shooting free throw shooter in the Southwestern Athletic Conference with an 87.9 percentage. Before tonight, she was 80 of 92 coming into tonight. I hope I didn't jinx her. She's one of one tonight shooting 50%. Here we go back the other way. The Panthers on the board with one. Right side, up top with it. Timmer swings it to Jordan Carter. Carter back left side, gives it up to Tenner. Here comes Tenner. She picks up some Birkin, and she's traveling, folks, and she's going across town. Folks, 1-0 if the, here comes Soders on the baseline, kicks it left side in the corner over to Roberson. Roberson thought about that baseline and gives it back up now to Payne. Payne will work left side. Wants to work on Tenner. Payne coming around the right side. Tenner cuts her off on the right. They're trying to get it in to Williams. She wants it. Smith loses it. And we'll go back the other way. And Roberson, no, don't call it. Golly gee. Now, we've got to be very careful, J-Rob. No sticking your hand in there. Reaching and picking up those little ticky-tack fouls. If you're going to foul somebody, me a fouler. No, I'm just teasing. Want to send a shout-out to the Roberson family in Indianapolis, Indiana. Thanks for watching. Left side, quick jumper from an Isaac Grant for two. And, folks, we're trying to keep up with the score. 3-1 the score. Roberson answers with another score. Right side way deep in the corner, shooting it from the right end right in front of Ms. Wanda, was warmly. And Payne will bring it back down on the left side. Folks trying to keep up with the score. I'm sorry, we've got a problem with our clock. Here we go, left side. Payne will have it. And looks like Williams is traveling. Need you to keep up with the score here. Two to three, the Panthers on top and wide open. Oh, man, and blew it there under the bucket. Amanda Blake had it. It was just too easy for her. 2-3, the Panthers are winning it. Payne, left side, gives it over to Smith. Smith, that's her favorite shot with a double pump, gets it blocked from behind. That time by Anaja Grant. We're going back the other way. Here we come up quickly on the left side. Wormsley kicks it left over to Carter. Carter throws it out of bounds off of, let's see, is that one going off of Smith? Yeah, Smith. Says it went off of me, coach. Dushan Prin has checked in. She is a junior from Boynton Beach, Florida. Quick turnaround and a foul on Roberson. Oh, my goodness, that's two on J-Rob early. Golly gee. And Maya Williams is going to come off the bench and replace her. Williams played some really, really good minutes for the Panthers on Friday, or Saturday, pardon me. Maya Williams, the sophomore from Copper City, Florida. The Southwestern Athletic Conference did a lot of shopping in the state of Florida last season. Recruiting season, that is. At the line, shooting two, Dushan Prin. Not too bad from the free throw line, 74%. The Grambling State Tigers shoot 70% as a team. Double pump with Ryan Payne in the paint for two. So that's going to be 5-2. The Panthers leading 5-2. Checking in is Tenner coming back. Williams coming to get some instructions from Coach Sandy Pugh, and here we go. Okay, we got it back going. We got the score going. 5-2. Thank you, ma'am. 5-2, 6:54 left to play here in the first quarter. The Big Dog coming to you courtside. 6:54 left to play as Payne drains that one to bring the score 6-2. Right side with it up top now is Tenner. Tenner gets it back up now to Prin. Prin left side. On the wing, the Carter looking down low. They give it in to Anaja Grant. Grant working from the right side, puts it in and out. Smith can't get it. Grant gets her own rebound and puts it back up for two. 6-4 the score here in the William Nix Center. Left side with it is Amaya Williams. Williams looking, taking it baseline, and a jump ball. Can't see the possession arrow. It's going to stay down on the Panthers side, checking in for Grambling State. Demaya Young, a sophomore from Manor, Texas, and also coming in for the Panthers, Jada Bowen, and also Michaela Hutchinson. Hutchinson and Bowen subbing in. Here comes Williams. Williams has it knocked away and has it taken away. And they're going to call Williams with the grab. after Williams had should have had the ball over her head, had it in the middle. 6-4. 6-4. 6:06 left to play here in the first. Here come the Tigers up top with it. Duchenne Prin will have it. Kicks it right side, wide open for three-point range is Young. She can't find a hole, but nobody blocked out Grant. 6-6 the score. Bowen coming left side, working on Tenner. Bowen now up to Smith, now over the clutch in the right elbow. Back out now to Smith. Smith looking down low, trying to find Williams. She's just going to have to shoot it. Williams gets it, and it's out of her hands, and we're going back the other way. The Panthers now with four turnovers. Here we go, left, right, over to Grant. Grant for two, no. Payne with the rebound in the fast break there, looking left side, trying to find Hutchinson in the corner. She'll take it herself with a double pump off the glass for two. Payne on fire again, folks. Good defense by the Panthers, folks. 8-6, the Panthers up two here. Here comes some mass substitution. Phaedra Green, love Phaedra Green, will check in for the Lady Panthers, who played some huge minutes for the Lady Panthers on Saturday night. Also checking in for Grambling State, Jordan Carter will come back in. Carter will go down on the left box. Bowen will run the point. Right side now to Payne. Payne over now to Williams in the corner to Phaedra Green. Green steps back, shoots it from 15. Looked good, just didn't fall. And we're coming back the other way with Carter. Carter in the middle, gives it up. In and out, rolls around for Amanda Blake. Senior from Somerville, South Carolina, will put it in for two and tie it up at eight. Payne for three. In and out, no good. Payne with the green light. Couldn't find the hole that time. Here we go, right side now with it is Wormsley. Wormsley kicks it all the way across to Carter. Carter running, putting it up. It's going to roll in for her on a shooter's roll. 10-8, the Grambling Tigers up by two. 4:18 left to play here in the first quarter. 10-8 the score. Left side with it, Payne looking. Twisting, turning, Bowen, wide open for three. Pow! Jada Bowen with a big three-pointer for the Panthers. 11-10, a one-point edge. Carter, no, check that, that's Prin. Really out of control. Tried to thread the needle of Bowen and Hutchinson, and they're going to give that one to Hutch. And, man, gee whiz. Not a favorable call for the Panthers, ladies and gentlemen, but I tell you what. Michaela Hutchinson's back in, all the way from La Paz, not Algiers, not the West Bank, and definitely not the North. We'll be right back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Resetting the Jumbotron. Folks, the score is 11-10. And we're Johnny on the spot. We're going to get it going here in just a few moments. 3:54 left to play here in the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers on top of the Grambling State Tigers, 11-10. Quick skirt right into the middle. Thank you, ma'am. Back up top, Carter will have it on the right side on the wing, working on Payne to Prin, left side. Now to Wormsley. Wormsley comes to the right side, throws it back up top now over to Demaya Young. Now back over to Carter, back to Young. Young loses it. Green comes up with it, gets it to Bowen, and we'll get it across the timeline. Here come the Panthers. Hutchinson, right side on the baseline. Steps, thought about the shot, and she'll reset it up. Left side with it. Payne has it. Now over to Smith from the elbow. That's her shot, in and out, no good. Green couldn't come down with it, and here come the Lady Tigers back the other way. Right side with it. Young has it in the corner, kicks it over now to Carter. Carter back up top now to Prin, and Prin will work the defense. Wormsley at the top of the key. Backs it out and takes it right. Smith picks her up right under Smith, throws it back outside, left side. Prin with the drive off the backboard, yeah. Woo, man, that's beautiful. Good transition by the Lady Tigers of Grambling State to go up by one, 12-11, with 2:43 left to play in the first quarter. Bowen on the left side, working on Prin, takes a baseline, stops, catches her off guard. Oh, Hutchinson with the fast break. Well, not the fast break, but trailing there down the middle. Wormsley got a hand on it. Here comes Soders back in for Hutch. And Hutchinson with some quality minutes. Bowen all the way up top to Payne, and Payne will look right side, gets it up now to Bowen. She thought about a three-pointer again. She's already hit one, and Prin is going to come up with the first, with her first personal foul. Prin will get it on the floor. That's going to be three for the Tigers. 14 fouls for the Panthers. Checking in will be Ariana Mosley, a freshman from Tampa, Florida, for Coach Courtney Simmons. Left side, Soders comes in, puts it up, no good from 20. Soders on the defense, comes right side. Great play by the Grambling State Tigers as Mosley gets rewarded with good defense and puts it off the glass. Here comes Bowen, now left side. Bowen brings it right. Working on Wormsley, gives it in now to Payne. Payne between the legs, turns, spins, man, what a move. Payne up and under, puts it in for a two. No, they're going to call traveling. Where are the Gold Cup members today? I'm going to have a real chat with them, Mia, about their attendance here. 1:53 left to play here in the first. Here comes Wormsley, kicks it down low and gets it to Tenner. Tenner with a turnaround, goes right side, puts it up off the glass. No, saved in by Smith to Soders, and Soders are kicking left side to Payne. Payne brings it right. Williams sets the pick. Oh, too quick. But that's the call you want. It goes out of bounds. They're on Amanda Blake, looks like. At any rate, the Panthers will get it back in for offense. Michaela Hutchinson, Smith, after some great defense, comes and sits it down here for a break. Soders to take it out for the Lady Panthers. Williams wants it, dump it in. Williams turns, twists, puts it up with the left hook. Oh, rolls in and out. No, Williams trying to get her own rebound, and she's going to clobber someone. And they're going to give that one over to Williams. That's going to be two on Williams or one, 44. It's going to be two on Williams. And the Lady Panthers are in the bonus there with that foul, and we'll take the long walk down. Smith will come in for Williams. Williams just really energetic there. And with two fouls, we would normally see Wormsley. Second shot is away. It's good. 16-11. Now the Tigers up by five. The Panthers need to score here. Soders will have it on the wing. Good defense. They give it over to Smith. Smith brings it around the right side at the top of the key. Yeah, we needed that one for two. Left side, Tenner gets it. Blake couldn't hold on to it. They give it back now to Payne, and Payne will slow it up at the top of the key. Payne with the crossover, comes left side, throws it in, dumps it over to Alice Smith. Smith in the paint, puts it up from two. No, Soders with the big rebound. She'll put it up from five. Yeah! Soders with a nice shot from behind the backboard to cut the lead to one with 36 seconds left to play. Tenner has it left wing. Good defense by the Panthers. Cut her off. They throw it all the way across court to Carter. Back up top to Wormsley. Wormsley with a roll. No. Here come the Panthers. Hutchinson brings it across court. Gives it up to Soders. Down to 16 seconds on the clock. Sitting back left side. Payne has it. Wants to work on Wormsley. Goes around the pick. Steps inside, now steps back, takes it right side, between the legs, misses it. Smith has to get it and put it back up. Oh! In and out, Smith with a great shot, but it just doesn't fall, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers, though, get within one, ladies and gentlemen. 16-15, the Tigers are up by one. Stick around, we'll be back with more. Exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M Panther Sports Network.
This here's a champ for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. James Crenshaw, want to send a shout out to the big boss. I didn't turn on any music coming back out of the break there. Again, the Panthers take it away. Here comes Michaela Hutchinson on the right side. Hutch in the clutch, and she's going to be fouled that time. Tenner is going to get her on the arm, folks. In the first period, the Panthers, not too bad. Could have done better. Shot 42.9% from the field. From the free throw line, they were 2 of 3, and only 1 3-pointer that came from Jada Bowen. Checking in for Grambling State is going to be Demaya Young. Hutchinson at the line trying to tie it up for Prairie View. No. The Panthers pretty good from the charity stripe. 71%. Not bad. You want to shoot around 80-84. And, oh, man, Hutchinson can't find it, but Soders chases down the rebound and, oh, throws it away. Oh, my goodness, the Panthers can't hold on to it. Here we go. Young on the fast break, puts it off the side of the iron. No. Hutchinson coming back down on the fast break. That's the game the Panthers want to play, an up-paced game, up-tempo game. Smith from the corner. No. Rebound by Smith. Back to Smith from three-point range. No. Soders with the rebound, and the Panthers with three rebounds. Right there, good defense by the Panthers. Defensive offense, folks, because they're guarding it and getting the rebound. A double pump off the glass. Clutch. Hutch in the clutch. off the glass for two. Michaela Hutchinson brought it all the way from La Place, Louisiana, baby. 9-12 left to play, 17-16. The Panthers go up by one. Man, what a great game in the early going here. 9-12 left to play here in the second, man, and some fast-paced action going here in the Baby Dome. Hutchinson shot his away. It's good. The three-point play, the Panthers take their biggest lead of the game at 2-18-16. In the next center, Wormsley accosted, throws it right side, gets it down the middle, in the corner to Carter for three, way off. Young gets the rebound. Left corner, the double pump from Jackson. I think that's Jackson, number four, just checked in. Jasmine Jackson just checked in for the Tigers. Wormsley gets it. Left side back out to Young for three. No, a mad scuffle for it, and it's the Panthers' ball. Great defense by the Panthers. Great volley by both teams, and Sandy Pugh loves it. Jasmine Jackson snuck in on us. She's a sophomore from Aubrey, Texas. And now LaFedra Green will come in and give Hutchinson a well-deserved breather. And Green, man, coming in with some real good energy. She's been just tremendous off the bench for Prairie View A&M. Soders to Smith now, back over to Smith. Kayla Smith, folks. Gerilyn Smith with a double pump off the glass. She's going to be fouled. Kayla Smith's in Kayla Smith's in the game with Gerilyn Smith. No relation, but both from Florida. Winter Haven and Miramar, respectively. And up off the bench, here comes another Floridian, Maya Williams from Copper City, Florida. Williams has played some huge minutes for the Panthers. And Smith really is having a hard time from the charity stripe. Usually a decent free throw shooter. Having a tough time today. Second shot is away. It's also no good. Wow. Wormsley in the paint. She's dangerous there. Puts it back off the glass all over the back where the Tigers. And timeout. Yeah, and a good timeout there by Ryan Payne, man. Payne gets the rebound and gets the quick timeout. We'll look at the replay here right quick. Payne. No replay now? Okay, 30-second timeout, folks. While we got this timeout, we want to thank all of you who are watching, especially our sponsors, Adidas, Sodexo, our friends over at Houston Methodist, and our friends over at the National Alumni Association. Thank all of you for all you do here for the Panthers of Prairie View A&M. 8-19. Left to play here in the first half. Folks, Charles Porter coming to you solo on the mic, but not without my sidekick, Mia Greer. I tell you, freshman Mia Greer from Houston, Texas, has come in and decided she's going to be my PA. And she told me earlier that starting today, she'll be telling me what to do, Crystal. The Panthers, folks, trying to keep it going here. 18-16, the Panthers up by two. The points in the paint, the Tigers are killing us with the second chance points. 12 points in the paint for Grambling State, 6 for the Panthers. The Tigers scoring 4 points off of the Panthers' 5 turnovers. The Panthers scoring 2 points off of the Grambling State 5 turnovers. .8-12 left to play here in the second. Here we go. Back left side there. Gerilyn Smith has it on the elbow. Smith coming around. Dumps it down low to Phaedra Green. Green with the turnaround in the paint. Doesn't stutter step there. Just couldn't get it over. The outstretched hands and cross-court pass over to Jordan Carter. And Carter couldn't hold on to it. Another turnover. Well, that's six turnovers by the Tigers of Grambling State. And here come the Panthers. Payne will have it up top. Payne, right side, gives it over to Smith. Smith looking right side. Out to Soders for three. It's good. No, off the mark. Here we come back left side. Carter Jackson, rather, has it. Almost has it knocked away. And Williams knocks it away. Here comes Williams on the fast break. Williams takes it with a double pump. Off the glass, can't finish. Don't stand there. Just go back and get it. No foul call. Miller, or Simmons rather, all over the official. She wants a foul call. Here we go back now, left side. Wormsley brings it back up top. Wide open for three. No. Smith comes down with another rebound, and we're going back the other way. Payne now getting instructions from Pugh to slow it down. Now gets it across the timeline. Takes it right side. Crossover dribble. Goes around the pick. Set by Green, and a foul called on Carter there. Swatting at the ball. Williams is going to come out with some quality minutes, and Hutchinson's going to come in, and the Panthers fighting in here, tooth and nail, 18-16. Still the score in the William Nix Center. Hutchinson throws it in to Payne. Payne will get worked on by Prien. Soders, left elbow to Smith. That's her shot there, folks. Smith, oh, man, air ball, though. It's off the mark. That's pretty much her spot. And we're going to take a look. 24, a foul on 2-4 on Grambling State. They're going to be a foul. Call from the other side. Demaya Young call for the foul. And that's going to be 17 fouls. Oh, no, they're going to call that a shooting foul. No team fouls for the Panthers. Five for the Tigers there. Five team fouls already. So the Panthers will be shooting two for the duration of this quarter. Smith's had it rough in the early going from the charity stripe. She's going to get it together now, though. Boom. Yeah. There we go. The Panthers lead by three. Shot is away. No good. Good job of blocking out there by Mosley. Here we come down. Prien, coast to coast, gets her own rebound. She was stepping out of bounds when she grabbed it. And the Panthers will get it back. Bowen will come in for Phaedra Green. Great job of coaching here tonight, folks. Pugh's at the top of her game with the subbing for her defense and offense, getting the players, getting fresh bodies in there. 19-16, a three-point edge. The Panthers have it. Bowen comes left side, challenging Young. There on the left side, goes around Young. Here comes Bowen with a double pump. Off the glass, kind of throws it up there, and it's going to go back the other way. But Bowen, not afraid. Takes it straight to the cup. I like it. 6:15 left to play here in the second quarter. Dushan Prien gets it back up top now to Casey Cheers. And a horribly missed three-point shot. Cheers. We'll check in. She's a graduate student from New Orleans, Louisiana. Timeout. Are they going to make it a full timeout? It's a full timeout here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 5:59 left to play. The Panthers lead it by three. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs, prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Those of you who are watching us on the Splendid Media Network, or listening rather, get a chance to hear my zaniness during the breaks, folks. The other night, Saturday, I got a little slap on the wrist. Accidentally played your playlist, Mia Grigg. Your fault. Here we go, back left side, Bowen. Looking in the corner for Soders. Working on Jackson. Soders, Smith at the left elbow. That's her shot. She'll step back and shoot it up. Off, oh man, and Ryan Payne goes way up high for the rebound and can't reverse it. And we're coming back the other way. Wide, oh man, nobody's under there blocking out Ariana Mosley. That's just too easy. We can't have a collapse on defense like that. Here we come back the other way. Bowen kicks it right side. Payne has it. Smith calls it. Wide open. Soders. That's it, baby. Three-point shot. Yeah, baby. And Soders with a big-time three. Soders comes back for the defense. Oh, and she's going to be called for the foul. Got it from behind, Soders. Golly G. Willikers. And the Grambling fans are really getting rowdy in our house. Where, oh, where are the goal members? 5 minutes left to play, 22-18. The Panthers on top. Jackson will go to the line to shoot some free throws. Not too bad from the charity stripe or the Grambling State Tigers. 70%, you know, we always talk about shooting around that 84 percentile mark. Jackson coming in tonight shooting 74%, 26 of 35. The Tigers coming off of a huge win against the Tigers of Texas Southern, a 15-point win, 60-55. As you know, the Panthers, folks, if you've been watching, lost a barn burner in overtime on Saturday to the Jaguars of Southern University. Okay, both shots are away, and they're good, so now the Panther lead down to two, 22-20. Left side, oh, bad pass by Smith. And here we go, left side, Wormsley takes it, and she's going to be hammered. That's 12, right? Wormsley going to the, yeah. Wormsley gets hammered from behind. And she'll go to the charity stripe for a free throw. Wormsley, their leading scorer at 10.4 points per game, is a 73% free throw shooter in conference. 17 of 23. Yeah, we jinxed her.
No, you jinxed her.
We're supposed to jinx the other team, Maya.
No,
I mean,
no,
Mia.
You jinxed Ryan.
I didn't mean to. I did jinx Ryan in the beginning. Now I'm getting fussed at. Here we go, right side. Payne now coming back left side. Looking for, oh, Hutchinson wanted it at that time. And now Payne is just going to take her time, D'd up by Jackson. Soders comes out on Wormsley. And right side with it, Payne now on the baseline. Thought about it, then steps back and shoots it up for three. Yeah. I see something special. I tell you, 25-20. The Panthers up five. Pugh is just off the chain over there on the sideline. Right side, there was Casey Cheers. They give it back up top. Here comes McKinney off the glass, working hard. Yeah, for two. Good job of getting Smith on her hip that time was McKinney, the junior from Washington, D.C. Here we go back right side. Good pass cross court now to Smith. Kayla Smith kicks it over left side, trying to get it to Soders. And, man, what a great job of recovering was Casey Cheers. Put on the afterburners and got over there and knocked it out of bounds for the Tigers. 25-22. Panthers up by a three-piece. Speaking of three pieces, I need to run the Popeyes. Hutchinson, left side, kicks it now to Payne. Hutch will get it at the wing. Works it left side to Smith. In the corner now to Smith. Smith to Smith. Soders fighting for the rebound. Kicks it in. Smith fighting for the rebound. Wormsley gets it. And it's too tall that time for Jasmine Jackson. And the Panthers, man, with some great defense here. This is getting good, folks. Panthers really, really, really close Saturday to getting back into the column. Grant's going to check back in. And also, Blake will check in for the Tigers. Amanda Blake, we're going to counter with Phaedra Green to have some muscle down there, down low. Soders comes off with a rest after a big three-pointer and some great defense. 3:26 left to play. Folks, tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10 about exciting Panther sports. We need this shared, shared, shared. Call folks. Tell everybody. Grab it here on the Prairie View A&M YouTube page. You can keep listening on the Splendid Media Network. Here we go. Back left side now with Payne. Back up top now to Maya Williams. Williams looking from the wing. Gets it back over to Payne with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Payne working on Wormsley. Green sets the pick. Payne now working on Grant with a double pump off the glass. Man, that's nasty. Whoa, man. I tell you, if she's not the newcomer of the year, I don't know who is. Oh, man, Jackson, man, with some great ball handling. Tries to thread the needle in that time to Grant. Good defense by the Panthers, man. They're feeling it tonight. Payne works it left side up off the bench. Now it's going to be McKinney. Here we go in the corner. No, Smith. Kayla Smith for three. No, but she's getting back on defense. Great. Here comes Jackson. Stops from five. Floater puts it in and one. Smith gets back and gets her on the arm. It's going to be her first personal foul. Great defense by Smith, man. Great hustle by Smith. And here comes, McKinney and Soders. McKinney for the Tigers, Soders for the Panthers. 2:22 left to play. Man, this is a good one, folks. Worth the price of the ticket. Worth the price of a click. Worth the time of a click to take the time to click to watch, right? Okay, that's right. 2:22 left to play. Mia Greer is really starting to have fun talking about the big dog behind his back as Jackson goes to the line for free throws. Jackson's shot is away. It's good. 27-24. The Panthers lead by three. Williams gets it over to Smith. Somebody's open. Here's Payne. Stops, spots for the three-pointer. Now steps in from 20. Puts it up. Boom. Boy, she's on fire. Payne with the last six shots. Williams tries to get it, and a foul's going to be called on Williams for going after it. Williams stepped over and fouled Chairs. Is that 13? And they're going to call that one on Chairs trying to go and get it. They're going to call it on the floor, though. The Panthers only with three team fouls. Now four. We've got one more to give here with 2 minutes left to play, folks. Well, 2:02, a couple of seconds until we get to crunch time. Wormsley to take it out. Left side gets it to Chairs, or Jackson, rather. Now to Chairs. Back up top to Wormsley. Wormsley bringing it left side. Blake wants to get involved. They kick it right side, wide open. On the left side, oh man, with a double reverse layup that time from Casey Chairs, man. That's Magic Johnson-ish. Watch it, folks. Here comes Wormsley. She gets it over to Chairs. She fakes the three-pointer. One, two, double pumps up under the bucket, the up and under. It's good for two. And she'll go to the line for the charity stripe. The Panthers are for the one and the and one, folks. 29-26. He can cut the lead to two. Jordania Ivy, the freshman from Tampa, Florida, has checked in for the Panthers. She can't get the rebound. She can't get the and one. And the Panthers get the rebound. Here comes Payne. Payne on the right side. Comes up, throws it up. Soders gets it. Oh, tries to get it quickly to Phaedra Green, but too quick. Wormsley brings it down right side. A two-point edge. They put it up. No, and Wormsley picked up some American Tourister. She's traveling, and the Panthers are going back the other way, baby. Hutchinson will check in for Maya Williams, and Williams with some real quality minutes. She has really stepped her game up here in the past few games, sending shots out to her folks. In Copper's Cove, not Copper's Cove, in Copper's Creek? No, where is it? Copper City, Charles. Copper City, Florida. Smith from the left elbow, or the right elbow, pardon me, for two. And now the Panthers, 31-26 the score on top of Grambling State. Warmly back up top to Ivy. And Ivy will take it right side over to Blake. Blake working on Smith, puts it up off the glass, in and out. No. Man, the Tigers can't buy a bucket tonight, and the fans are a little quiet over there. Payne across the timeline, right side to Soders. Soders. Left wing to Hutchinson. Green waiting on, waiting right there on that baseline. Hutch wants to take the shot. Here comes the dribble drive from 10. Side of the iron, no good. McKinney comes down with the rebound, and Warmly will bring it back up left side. Playing for the last shot, folks. 31-26. Panthers up five here in the second quarter, down to 14 seconds. Warmly wants to get one-on-one and work on Soders. Here comes Warmly. Nope, she's going to stop. Kicks it inside to McKinney. McKinney to work on Green. Soders. Oh, come on! Soders hit all ball there. You got to show that replay. They're going to call that one on Soders, but that looked like all ball. Here's the replay. Warmly, folks. Check it out. Warmly gets it into McKinney. Green. Running back again there, DJ. And well, look, looks like Soders did get her on the wrist. That's a good call. Here it is again. Yeah, well, a little bit is a lot. Right here we go. Soders recovers right there. Powell gets her on the arm. Good call by the officials. Hey, McKinney on the line shooting free throws. First one's in the way, no good. Smith up off the bench. This is really getting good, folks. You need to call everybody you know and say, man, it's hot in the baby dome, baby. Second shot is away. It's no good. And here come the Panthers now with 1 second left to play. Man, the Panthers are really burning it up here in the baby dome tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! It's getting hot in here. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence, as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
And the Associate Athletic Director, Miss Alicia B. Standing on the court, receiving those pink bands from Director Anton Goff and Miss Alicia B are Dr. Lorraine Foster, Dr. Carla Lee, Melanie Porter. One more time, Panther fans, a warm Panther round of applause for our breast cancer survivors.
Cheerleaders! All right, Panther fans, welcome to the court. The one, the only, the crew.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Hey, John, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the William Nix Center. Charles Porter coming to you with Mr. Donald Carroll of Woodlawn Entertainment and Ms. Mia Greer, our personal assistant. The Panthers, man, doing pretty good. 31-26, shooting 38% from the field. Grambling shooting 42%. The Panthers shooting, well, is that right? 30% from the three-point range on three three-pointers, three of four. And 18 rebounds for the Tigers, 19 for the Panthers. We best them by one. We're knotted up at assists. Ryan Payne leads all scorers with 15 points. For Prairie View, you got 6 and 4. Or pardon me, 15 points for the Panthers. A couple of nicks from Soders and Smith. Did you get that? A couple of nicks, a couple of nickels, 5 points apiece from Soders and Smith. Soders comes in and pumps in 6 rebounds. That's huge off the bench. On the other side of the ball, well, kind of well-rounded rebounding. 2 for Jasmine Young, 2 for Young, 2 for Warmly, and 2 for Brenda McKinney. So kind of even here. The Panthers leading, though, by 5, ladies and gentlemen, 26-31. And one that proves to be good. Still working on our scoreboard and our Jumbotron. Down to 10 seconds left to play. The Panthers are going to go back with their starters. Well, they're going to add Soders. So Roberson, who had to go out with 2 fouls, is back in the lineup. Roberson, Payne, Soders, Smith, Geraldine, and Williams. Looks like they're going to go back with their starters. Coach Simmons going back with Warmly, Grant. Is that McKinney over there? Let's see. Warmly, Grant, McKinney. Their starters was Blake Carter, Warmly, Tenner, and Preen. Dushin Preen. So Tenner, Warmly, McKinney, Tenner, and Blake. Going back with their starters, folks. Once again, Carter, Warmly, Grant, Blake, and McKinney. The Tigers will get possession here in the first round, and they'll be traveling right. The Panthers traveling left. The Panthers need to play some good defense. Stay in the game. Play smart. Keep hitting the shots. Here we go. Left corner. Blake throws it down the middle. Tenner has it from 5. It's going to creep out, and snatching it down in the land of the big men is J. Del Robinson. Roberson with it left side. Oh, has it knocked out of her hand. Lazy, a simple, easy turnover. That's a mistake we shouldn't have made, especially if they hit 2 points off of it. Yeah, and they do. Capitalize on the mistakes. Tenner hits it from 15. Soders to Roberson. Great pass. Roberson way high off the backboard. Williams going in, getting it. Roberson trying to save it. And we're going back the other way, and we got to hit those easy ones. Here comes Michaela Hutchinson right up off the bench, and Jay Robson, hold on, coach. Let me get the – hold on, coach. Come on. I love it. I'm sorry, man. Roberson said, hey, look, I got it, coach. Let me in the game. And she's going to keep Roberson in there. Roberson now with 3 fouls. She's got to be careful and got to play up to par. Here we go, left side with it. Tenner travels, no call. They kick it back out, left side now to Carter. And Carter will bring it to the top of the key. Right side, Tenner. Dribble drives, throws it way over to Warmly. And it goes off in the hands of Gerald and Smith. And it'll stay down on the Tiger side with 12 seconds on the shot clock. 8:53 left to play here in the third. 31-28, the Panthers by 4. Pardon me, 3. Carter to Tenner. Back over to Warmly. Warmly brings it back out on the wing, kicks it in the corner now. Here comes Carter on the baseline with a double pump. No, and Williams is going to get called for that one. That's her third. She got it with the body there. She stepped in to take away the baseline, but got her with the body. Here's the play. Thank you. Here comes Warmly. She brings it back out. Now kicks it back down left on the corner. And watch Williams step in right there. Trying to cut her off on the baseline. She's already there. She couldn't get there in time, so. Man, So now, Williams has got three fouls. And I want to make a correction. Roberson only has two fouls. So the only real trouble we're in is with Williams. Here comes Phaedra Green off the bench. We'll leave Williams in for offense. Here we go back across the timeline. Smith has it. Into the hands of Soder. Soder's right side back cross court to Payne. Payne gets it back to Soder. Thought about the three. Dumps it down. Too low. Too long for Williams. And Williams has to run the floor. Wide open. Carter thought about it. Gives it back up to Warmly. She'll dribble drive. Steps in from 20. Hits the back of the iron. No. Tenner with a rebound. On the baseline. Tenner turns around trying to get Williams. And she travels. Picks up an extra step. And, man, really bails out Williams, who was really poised to get that foul. I want to send a shout-out to Marissa Nicole. Hey, Marissa. What's going on, Sarah? Also, Eric Juarez is watching. I will see him on Wednesday when the Panthers take on the Bison of North Dakota, an exciting women's softball. I am so excited about them, but not about throwing the ball away right there. Blake gets it to Warmly. She's got the numbers. Tenner from the corner brings it to the baseline. Right up in the middle is Blake. Blake can't hit it. Man, the Tigers just can't find the hole. Here comes Warmly. Right side. Tenner for three. No. A mad scuffle and a tie-up between Payne and looks like Blake. And we'll go back the other way. Prien will come back in, and Hutchinson will come back in for the Panthers. And Payne calling the troops together and saying, hey, let's settle down here a minute. 7:40 left to play. The Panthers up 31-29. Payne to Smith to Hutchinson. Right side now to Payne. Payne backs it out and throws it over to Soder. Soder has to knock it away because we're a little Harry Carey out there, folks. We got to slow the ball down. Make some good passes. We got plenty of time. You're rushing. So I'm sure. Ooh. Coach Pugh not happy about it. Here we go. Oh, Prien with a great move. That takes it, oh, man, all the way coast to coast. Man, that was nasty. Wow. Duchenne Prien. Ties it up for the Tigers. Here comes Payne. Payne. Not bothered at all. Ah, off the side of the iron. It's no good. Here come the Tigers of Grambling State. Prien working on Soders. Here comes Prien right side. She takes the dribble drive. Kicks it off on the left side. Now to Blake. Blake from the left block puts it in for two. And the Tigers go up by two. The Panthers were leading. And the Grambling State Tigers come hustling back. 6:45 left to play here in the third quarter. The Tigers up by two.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. 33-31, the Tigers have crept back into this one and taken the lead. The Panthers now with 10 turnovers. The Tigers with 13, but in the rebounding, the Tigers are one better, 22-21. Payne bothered by the full court press. .636 left to play. She's in the front court. Okay. Here comes Payne. Payne brings it across the timeline. Carter with some good defense. Right side, Michaela Hutchinson. Hutchinson back up top now to Payne. Payne looking right side to clutch. Green with 5 seconds on the shot clock. Smith's got to do something with it. Out to Payne. Payne steps back for three. Pow! On the buzzer beater. Wow! Ryan Payne with a big three-pointer for the Panthers. Here comes Warmly. Now over to Prin. Prin looking down low, trying to get it to Blake. Blake wants to work on Phaedra Green. McKinney. Right side to Prin. At short. The Panthers come down with it. Here comes Hutchinson across the timeline. 5:44 left to play here in the third quarter. Payne back up top now to Hutchinson. Right side over to Soders. Soders to Smith. She wants to take Blake. That's her shot off the backboard. No. And Prien, who's really quick, quick as a cat, gets it out to Carter. Here comes Carter. Loses it. And we're going back the other way. And now the Tigers playing a little Harry Carey. Sending shots out to Santoria Black and his crew down at Grambling State University. Santoria and I go a long way back, like Ray Goodman and Brown. 5:19 left to play in the third. Only old school people would have known that, Mia. Right side now. Hutchinson, reverse layup. No! Just couldn't get the spin. Getting back on defense, though. Great move. Here comes Prin weaving, bobbing through the offense. Throws it over to McKinney. No. And we're going back the other way. Here comes the Panthers. Or pardon me, I keep saying McKinney. That's Grant, 15. Payne. Looking back up top. Hutchinson will reset the offense and give it over to Soders. Soders back over to Hutchinson. They're going to guard Payne at all costs. Hutchinson coming left side, coming right. Oh, tried to get it over to Payne in the corner, and Warmly with an easy one. Phaedra Green by herself in the back and gets the foul. Needed the and one, but Green goes straight to the bucket. Blake has to come from behind and commit the foul now with 4:22 left to play. That's going to be only one foul apiece for both teams here in the paint. Golly gee willikers. The Panthers now are down by 2:35:33. Stick around, folks. We'll be back with more. This is exciting Panther basketball.
Go. can make it rain. Now make it clap for me, you drive me crazy. I know you want me, cause I want you, girl. Tell me, can we kick it tonight? Lights, camera, action, I'll play director. Turn you out, let me sneak a peek. Turn you out on the late night creep. Ain't no playing no games tonight.
She likes Young Shado. Let me give her my side of the story.
I can tell the way she watching me. She love the way I swag it out. Got enough to go around, I might as well pass it out. Today she like the way I work her out until she passing out. Wanna be with a star, well mama, I'm an astronaut. Let her lick the rapper, I call that the jawbreaker. If her back was the law, then call me a lawbreaker. Love the way she roll her hips, it's like she on a bean. Drop to make her lose her voice like she on the scream machine. She say,
Center, ladies and gentlemen, Green at the free throw line. After a pretty good play, the officials making sure. I don't know what the officials were unsure of, but Green with a couple of big free throws, or with one free throw to cut the lead to 134-35. The turnaround from Grant, and it's going to go out of bounds on. Is that going to go out on Payne? Payne, okay, it'll go out on Payne, and we'll stay down here with 20 seconds on the shot clock, folks. Here we go, right side now. Jackson has it. Jackson back up top, left side to Warmly. Now to Prince. He's quick as a cat with a spin. Oh, man. Boy, that was kind of Jordan-ish. There, boy, she is too quick. Somebody get on her. Payne, oh man, with a stop and put back. Oh man, she'd have hit that one, the crowd would have liked it. And here comes Warmly. Warmly pushes it down right side, throws it too far over right. There for Jasmine Jackson, and here comes McKinney. McKinney and Grant has the very same hairstyle. Easy to, well, if you're just looking at the hair, I guess. Yeah. Coming back in for the Panthers is going to be Bowen. And Williams will get a break. Now, come on here, J-Rob. Let's be smart here. Offense for defense. Roberson coming in for defense. Or, pardon me, for offense. Smith to Smith. Pardon me, Bowen to Smith. Smith with on the left side. Kicks it back over now, right side to Bowen. Bowen backs it out down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. Working on Jackson. Here comes Bowen. Bowen in the paint. Gets it over to Hutchinson. For three. Looks good. It's off the mark. Put that right up under the bucket. No, was Ryan Payne, and she can't finish the putback. Prince, somebody stop the ball. Is anybody going to stop the ball? Prince just goes right down the darn lane. Golly gee. Now the Tigers up by three, 37-34. Come on, ladies, put your head in the game. Bowen to Smith. Smith puts it up from the free throw line. Yeah, that's her shot. Jackson to Prien, to Jackson right side, cut off by Bowen. McKinney kicks it to Warmly on the baseline. Cut off, great job, but man, she finishes. Off the glass for two, 39-36, back to a three-point edge. Bowen brings it right side. Jackson riding her like a horse. And that's going to be the second team foul. Not a lot of team fouls here in the third quarter. Carter will check back in for Jackson. Bowen kicks it back out from Roberson. And here we go back right side. Here comes Jalen Smith. She'll stop, spot from 15. Oh, it's off the mark. And here comes Warmly. Warmly with a quick one down on the right side. Here comes Carter. Carter, left side. Puts it right in the middle over the pre. Oh, man, that's easy and beautiful. Wow, what a play. Oh, my goodness, man. That's just good basketball. 41-36. The Panthers now need to stay here. Right side with it. Smith over to Green. Now Green wants to take it to the bucket. Oh, and Green's going to be fouled. Riding her on the back there just slightly was Brenda McKinney. I'm with you, McKinney. I don't know, Mr. Official. Let him play. Now watch this. Here, now she just bumped her right there. DJ, that's just a bump right. G. Willikers, I'm not questioning because it's going our way. Here comes Payne. She'll get it. Friend, the best defender out there for the Tigers. I was all over Payne like a glove, but I tell you, if it doesn't fit, she must have quit. And she does there. Pow! Oh, no, she missed it. How can you blow it like that for me? Warmly right side now gives it over to Friend. Duchesne Friend thinking about it. Owen Roberson, J. Robb, yeah. She's trying to catch J. Robb. She slid that foot. And J. Robb getting ready to put down some clamp down defense. Here comes Williams and Hutchinson. Roberson, Green is going to come out along with Bowen. Great job. Good to see Kayla Smith back out there on the bench, sitting right next to Soders, ready to get in for the Panthers. Maya Williams comes right side. She's a quick one. Williams brings it across the timeline quickly. Man, she's weaving and bobbing her way off through the defense. Williams comes now left side, kicks it in the corner. Smith thought about it, now wants to work on Blake. Sizing her up, takes a left side baseline. Off the glass for two. Great move by Smith to get Blake on her hip for the easy one down to under a minute. Left to play here in the third quarter. 3-point edge, double pump. And that one's going to go against Hutchinson. Well, we got three people around. It's going to go against Hutchinson. No, three? Yeah, Hutchinson. That's going to be two on Hutchinson. Want to send another shout out to LaPlace, Louisiana. You know, I just butchered her hometown. I called her from Algiers. Well, I knew she was from LaPlace, but I was just teasing. I called Algiers, the Ninth Ward. What else did I call? I didn't say Metairie. I could have called Metairie. You don't know anything about those places. Shell's Daiquiri Shop in Metairie. That was my cousin. Here we go. Warmly at the line, shooting free throws. Warmly shooting 73%. Didn't get it out in time. She hits the first one. Warmly will have one more. Second shot is away. Hits the back of the iron. No. Good defense and good way of job of getting the rebound by Grant. Grant kicks it back out to Warmly, right side to Prince. Prince, she's so quick, throws it right into the hands of Bowen. And, well, Roberson, rather. And now, with 24 seconds left to play in the third quarter, Ryan Payne has it left side. 42-38 the score. 42-38 to score. It's a little behind on the screen. Here we go. Left side in the corner. Wide open. Hutch thought about it. Now puts it up for three. Hits the back of the iron. No. What? Oh, a foul? I'm sorry. A foul on Williams pushing in the back. And we'll have 5 seconds left here. Hutch will take a seat and get a break. And that's going to do it for the third quarter, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers Down by four here, 38-42. 38-42 with 10 minutes left to play. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 9:56 left to play here in the fourth quarter. And an easy floater there from Anaja Grant. The Panthers in the third quarter shot 23%. And an early foul here in the fourth quarter coming against Anaja Grant. That's going to be on the floor. 9:35, that's going to be her third personal here in the fourth quarter. Simmons can't stand it. And now we're going to bring in, see, that's a smart move now. Pugh brings in Williams to work. Well, wait a minute, who's got three? They're going to work that one. 323 has three. The board's going tricky again. Williams trying to throw it out to Smith, throws it away in the corner. Prin for two. Gosh. 9:27 left to play, 46-38. Now quick 8-point edge here in the fourth quarter. Payne with a spin, puts it up. Payne's getting cold. Good job of keeping it alive by Roberson. Payne comes back. It's going to roll in and out. Oh, no. And we're going back the other way. Prince quick in the paint. Puts it up. Oh, taken away by Rob. J-Rob takes it away. Roberson brings it back. Make him pay, Roberson. There you go. Puts it up from five. No. And we'll keep it down on our end. 22 seconds on the shot clock. 8:52 left to play. Here comes Soders and Hutchinson. Williams will take a seat. Oh, Roberson with some great defense. You just got to hit those points. And I really like Roberson's game, man. I tell you. Keep J-Rob in the game. Quickly in now to, and a foul called a push on Anaja Grant. Now, that's going to be three. Grant's got 15. She's got two. That's going to be three on Grant. Not going right at her. Go right at her, coach. Don't let him sub in. Get Grant out of the game. Grant and Blake, the big men for the Tigers. Hutchinson brings it to the top of the key. Kicks it left side over to Payne. Payne looking. Trying to get the pick down to 13 seconds on the shot clock. Puts it right side in the corner. Oh, man, lazy pass. Good defense by the Tigers. Soders was waiting on the baseline for the shot. Now they're slowing it down. 8:29 left to play. 46-38, an 8-point lead. We blew an opportunity there. Warmly coming down right side. Carter running the baseline. Friend Picks up her dribble right side warmly for three. Looks good. Ooh-wee. We've got to get in their face. Here comes Maya Williams. Williams had some good defense there on Warmly. And Pugh wants a timeout. And, yeah, rightfully so. I want to take it with her, ladies and gentlemen. 7:54 left to play here in the fourth quarter, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers down 49-38. Wow. We'll be back with more.
Yeah, this is a story of famous dog. For the dog that chases its tail, we'll be busy.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Hey, John. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
We're back live here in Prairie View, Texas. The Panthers on a couple of turnovers. Three turnovers have let the Grambling State Tigers get the advantage here. An 11-point edge, 49-38. Plenty of time, 7:50 left to play. Williams now in the forecourt now working on Carter. Gets it on the right side now to Smith. Smith down low trying to dump it down. To Williams, and here comes Carter. And she'll be fouled in Soders. We'll commit the foul. Golly gee, ladies, come on now. Carter. To the line for the Tigers, Carter. 0-2, 1-2 today. 1-2 from the charity stripe. That one falls for. And looking at that rebounding category, the Tigers out rebounding now. The Panthers 31-26, and they take it again. And almost get another rebound. They've out rebounding the Panthers now by 5. It was real even at the half. It was 17-18. And now the Panthers are having some difficulty in the paint with the Grambling State Tigers. Young will check in for the Tigers. Demaya Young, the sophomore from Manor, Texas, right down the street here. Not down the street, but I know where Manor is. Here we go back now. Smith with the turnaround jumper, double pump. She's fouled, and we'll get the call I was about to say. Young is going to come right in and pick up a quick one. That's three on Demaya Young, now 7-19. We've only got Williams in danger. Bowen now will come in for Maya Williams. Smith. Have you ever seen a police officer in effect? No, I was just checking. Yeah. 7:19 left to play, 50-38. I'm just teasing with Officer Childs there. She's our protection there, Maya. That's our personal protection. First shot is away from Smith. It's good. Now that'll cut the lead 39-50. We need this one to cut it to 10. Second shot is away. It's good. Now it's a 10-point lead, 50-40. The Panthers got a lot of time in here. Defense, we've got to play some defense. Three stops, we're right back in it. Prien from the left wing looking, kicks it in the corner, gets it over now to Carter. Carter back up top, Prient working on Ryan Payne, kicks it in the corner. Wide open for Young, man. And now, Grambling State starting to stretch their muscles. Here comes Bowen. Bowen brings it left side over to Payne. Payne thought about the three-pointer, works on Prient. Ooh, got Prient. And Prient hit all ball. Got a little arm on that one, but Prient, Dushan Prient, and Ryan Payne are going at it. And Prient, I'm very, very impressed with her. She's a man, quick as a cat. 6:37 left in this one, folks. For those of you who are going to watch the men's game coming up, both teams coming in 9-7-4. Both teams are, 9-3. Both team, men and women's team, came in 9-3 tonight. Bowen will have it right side. Here come the Panthers. Payne has one creep in for her. 42-53. Carter thought about it. We'll keep it on the wing. Carter kicks it outside. Payne steals it away. Here come the Panthers. Payne with an easy one. And a blocking foul there on Warmly. Payne getting up slow. Payne playing in pain. I don't know if it was her ankle or knee. Something's or her hip. Ankle, knee, or hip. Something on her right side's been ailing her. And understand, talking with Coach Danny Evans earlier today, she's been playing hurt for the last few games. So hats off to Ryan Payne doing it for Prairie View. I want to send a shout out to Adrian Johnson, watching us on the Splendid Media Network. All of you who are watching or listening can hop on over to the Prairie View A&M Athletics YouTube page. The Prairie View A&M YouTube page. And watch the video and the audio. You can get the video and audio. Man, I'm telling you, it looks really good, too. Courtesy of Woodlawn Entertainment. Here comes the second shot. It's away, and it's good. 5:55 left to play. 53-44 the score. Prien. Panthers with full court pressure. Smith working on Prien. Wide open is Young again for three. Two in a row. Oh, man. Wow. 56-44. Tigers up 14 now. Bowen loses it, gets it back from Williams. Bowen, oh, man, with a nice shot, but can't finish. And we're going back the other way. Here comes Prient. Prient all the way down, coast to coast. And they're going to call a foul on Soders, really? Soders had her feet. Wait a minute. Let's see. They're going to consult with that one. Soders was standing straight up. Here comes the replay. Soders, let's see. Does she get her feet stopped? No, that left foot was not planted. And it's going to be a foul on Soders. Yeah, blocking foul, left foot wasn't planted there, folks, if you watch it. Bowen will check out. Prien. Shot is away, no good. Boynton Beach, Florida. Dushan Prien. Shot is away, it's good. Williams. Starts right, now comes left. She's going to get trapped. Gets it in the middle over to Smith now. Here we go. Payne thought about the three-pointer. Now steps inside, shoots it from 15. That's good. Well, Payne should be at her average around 18 points here. Prient all up under control. Running without being under control. Comes down on the left side. Soders had her heel stepped on. Now she's coming down late. Williams brings it right, working on Prien. Now over to Payne. Payne now bringing it left side. With a double pump, she's going to be fouled by Young. Mosley coming over trying to give a little help. And here's Williams now taking her right. Now in the Payne. Payne's going to take the left side there. And Young right there gets her with the foul. Grant's going to check in. Carter will take a seat. Kayla Smith back in for the Panthers. And Payne will go to the charity stripe. 4:25 left to play in this one, folks. 46-57. Shot is the way it's good from Payne. That's a 10-point lead. Payne can cut it to 9. Couple of stops and 2 3-pointers. We're right back in it. That one is the way it's good. Now it's a 9-point lead. We need a steal. We need something big. And here's Maya Williams with a jump ball. And it should be down there with the Panthers. Maya Williams, 2 steals. That's all we needed. Here comes Warmly back off the bench. I just called it. We need a stop. Now we need a couple of big shots here. Prien is going to get a break for those last few minutes. They dump it in now to Williams. Williams out now. To Williams. Now back out to Ryan Payne. Payne with the green light. Gives it over to Maya Williams. Williams, they want to get it into Payne's hand because he's got the hot hand. Payne down low. Gets it over to Amari Williams. Williams working on Blake. Kicks it in the corner. Wide open is Kayla Smith. Oh, man, that looked good. Ah! Missed it by that much, folks. And here comes. Oh, that's going out on Young. Young tried to do it all by herself. Goes off on her leg. The Panthers get it again. Wow. Carter getting back in the game for the Panthers. Man, great job by Smith and Williams off the bench. Maya Williams and Kayla Smith. We've got 2 and 2, 2 Williams and 2 Smiths, but those are the two we're referring to. Here we go right side. Williams in the corner. Smith for 2. No, we needed that one. Here we come back right side. Mosley back to Blake. Gets it into the hands of Warmly, the point guard. And now Warmly's going to work on Smith. Smith with the clamp down defense. Here comes Warmly on the right side. Warmly cut off by Williams. Great defense in the corner. Steps in. Smith gets it. Oh, man, the Panthers almost steal it away. Here comes Warmly down with 3 seconds on the shot clock. She can't do anyway. She's just got to throw it up there. And shot clock violation. And it's going back the other way. Great defense by the Panthers. Great defense. 3:09 left to play, folks. 57-38. We need a score here. Off the bench, Jada Roberson. And Williams will come and take a seat. Roberson back over now to Payne. Smith will get it. Oh, Roberson wide open. Roberson with a reverse layup puts it up, and it's blocked. Oh, my goodness, and we're going back the other way with Warmly. Warmly comes up with it. Going left side, working on Roberson. Roberson tries to go around the left. Now here comes Warmly, finds a lane, and puts it up for 5. Payne hits the ground hard, and she's got to run and shake that one off, man. I tell you, she's tough as nails. Prien checks in. Well, And Payne tells J-Rob, I'm good. I might not be from South Central, but I'm from California, and I've driven through the neighborhood, so I'm tough. How about that? Payne at the line for free throws, 48-59. Payne can cut the lead to 9 points. 2 minutes and 29 seconds left to play. Shot is away. It's good. Want to send a shout out to the Prairie View Trail Riders. Heading towards Hockley tomorrow. We'll be right down the street from our house. Me and Mama say we're going to walk down there. Have you ever been to the trail ride, Mia? You've never been on a trail ride? She's looking at the Grambling State Tigers fuss. Here we go, right side. Prien steps back. Down to 9 seconds left. Prien tries to put it up, and a foul. Going to call that one on Michaela Hutchinson, or they're going to get that one with J-Rob. Roberson's going to get that one. Here comes Prien looking, trying to take Hutchinson. She got Hutchinson going right, and Rob had to come over and help. Good move. 2:05 left to play, a 10-point lead. First shot is away. It's no good. Shot is away. It's good. 50% is Prien. Roberson. Now to Williams in the corner. To Smith. Smith now to Payne from 5 for 2. 8 point lead. No, 9 point lead now. Down to 1:43 left to play. And Payne has to foul Prien to try to stop the bleeding here. And the bleeding is the shot clock. Warmly, the Panthers had a foul to give. We've got one more to give here. Warmly working on J-Rob. Roberson with a good recovery. Blake, man, misses that one terribly. And Grant has it blocked around the back, and here we go back the other way. Great pass over to Roberson. Roberson and one. Yeah, baby. And one. And that's what I'm talking about. 1:16 left to play. Man, watch this fast break. Great job by Roberson. Good control. Puts it and one. Watch the official. Yeah, baby. And one. 1:16 left to play. The lead is 7. The Panthers. Roberson can now cut it to 6. Roberson. Drops it. And the Panthers can't get a hold to it. Here comes Warmly down on the right side. 1:11 left to play. The Panthers got a foul quickly here. Under a minute left to play. Down 6. She's saying foul her. Yes, ma'am. My personal assistant told me to sit myself down. I'm moving too much. Well, it's not my fault. The television doesn't have a stand on it. She's been one of one. Prien has been 1-1 from the charity stripe all night long. Hits the first one. Gee whiz. Wow. One more. Shot is away. No good. She's been 50%, and they're going to call a foul on Anaja Grant over the back of Amari Williams. That's going to be 5 fouls for the Tigers. We'll take the long walk down. That's the 1-1. And you look at it over the back there of Smith, Grant, that's three on an Elijah Grant. Young will come in for Carter. So Grant, Friend, Blake, Young, and Carter out for the Tigers. Roberson, Williams, Soders, Smith, and Payne for the Good Gals. Shot is away. Ah, it's good. Smith with a clutch free throw. 61-54. 51 seconds left to play. Folks, hopefully we'll chat with either Jeanette Jackson or Danny Evans after the game. Break this one down. Don't forget exciting men's action coming your way about 20 minutes after this one. Second shot is away. It's good. Now 55-61. Back to a six-point lead. And a timeout call. The final timeout for this one, folks. We'll take a break here. We'll take a 30 and come back with the final 51 seconds. It's going to be good. Stick around.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
The 24th and 25th of March. Mark your calendars. March 24th and March 25th. The annual running of the Prairie View A&M University Relays. We'll be right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M next month. Can't wait. Neither can Mia. Hopefully next year she'll be out there running in the Prairie View Relays. Thinking about it and saying, I don't know, huh? They sure been running a lot. Well, warmly to take it out for Prairie View. Soders on the end of the pass. Quick one to Prin and a foul. That's it. Wow. Well, folks, Prin with the quick one towards the bucket. And Williams fouls her. Nobody cut her off in the front. She's been 50% all night from the charity stripe. Hits the end of it. 64-55, 9 points. Down to 44 seconds left to play. And Williams with a hard foul. Williams, and that's going to be five for Williams. And Williams she just put a wall up and said, here, try to run through this wall. And she's going to have to take a seat. Well, folks, the Panthers fought valiantly. Was in it all the way here until the last 7 minutes of the fourth quarter. And gee whiz. Man, the Panthers just couldn't get it done. Folks, don't fret. Exciting men's action coming your way. Men lost to Southern by 6 points on Sunday night. The ladies lost by seven. The men lost by six. And gee whiz. It was tough. 42 seconds left to play coming up this Wednesday. The Panthers will finally get on that brand new, the softball team rather, we'll get on that brand new softball field. If you go to Raymond Holly, G-Boom Panthers, go to G-Boom's Flickr account and you can see the brand new scoreboard being hoisted up and set in the piles and get welded in. Here we go, right side warmly with it down to 40 seconds. They're going to have to foul her quick. Soders grabs her on the right shoulder and they finally stops the clock there with 37 seconds left to play. Warmly, 73% free throw shooter. Tonight, not so good. 1 of 4, Warmly from the free throw line. Shot is away, no good. We're jinxing her already. Students out in attendance, if your child goes to prayer, if you call her right now or him right now and say, get over there to that game and support your Panthers. Shot is away, no good. Missed both of them in a timeout call by the Panthers. 36 seconds left to play. Well, we'll need at least three. Folks, don't forget, March 24th and 25th, the annual running of the Prairie View A&M University Relays. I think it's going to be the 54th running of the Prairie View Relays. I'll check to make sure. 36 seconds left here in this one. Want to send a few pleasantries out to some family members. My brother, Garland Coleman, retired from UPS, 40 years at the United Postal Services, or the Brown folks, yeah. Let's go ground and let's go brown. UPS, 40 years, so proud of you. Also want to send a shout out to Lorenzo and Hosanna Porter. I don't know if Miss Lex is watching, but Burpee should be. How about that? 36 seconds left. Panthers going to go back with Soders, Roberson, Hutchinson, Smith, and Payne. Carter. Grant, Blake, Prien, and Warmly, all for Grambling State. Soders throws it in. Jay Robb takes it to the baseline. Throws it, all out in the corner. And did Payne slip or was she pushed? And Payne just kind of pushed Hutchinson. Hutchinson's going to pick up the foul. And that's going to send Carter for free throws. Jackson will come up off the bench and get Prien out. And here comes Maya Williams for Jada Roberson. Well, folks, keep it right here. Exciting men's action coming your way. For those of you watching us on YouTube, you're going to have to reload the stream. You have to reload the stream for those on Splendid. Just keep it right here. We'll let you see the pregame, and then we'll turn it away. First shot is away, no good. 64-55. Second shot is away. It's also no good. Blake chases it down, and they're just going to run this one out of here. Down to 20 seconds. Warmly. Down to 4 seconds, 3-2-1. That's going to do it. 64-55, folks, the score. Here in the William Nix Center, the Panthers had a rough go of it. Stick around. We'll wrap these up here in just a few moments. Come back with more exciting Panther basketball as the men get ready to take on the Tigers of Grambling State. Hit that reset button, folks. We'll wrap up this game in the pregame of the men's contest. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.